guess I need to turn towards the light. Hello. Let me give folks a little bit of time to come in and such. Soul of Cinema. Hello, hello. How's everybody? I'm back. So I do owe y'all explanation and people that were here that weren't here earlier for my other impromptu scope. My scope did drop when I tried to flip the camera. Hey. It did. Right, the real Running Man. What is this stuff they doing now? So it did freeze, but then my daughter had some weird allergic reaction. I'm trying to light an incense. My fan is blowing. My daughter had some weird allergic reaction, and apparently this is a thing for her to do. Hey, this is a thing for her to do in the summertime. So when we looked it up, apparently my daughter has like a sun allergy. At Kai Sano, I was like, but you black. How you got a sun allergy? So I had this viewer question a long time ago. Well, not a super long time ago, but from Omisore, I think. Thank you. It's because I did decide I was gonna start my locks again, so we're gonna see. So I wanted to go ahead and do her question. She asked me on Instagram, and I do take viewer questions. If y'all ever have questions, y'all can inbox it to me. I will do an entire thing on it. So she asked me, why do I call myself a guide instead of a coach? And then she was asking me about people that refer to themselves as spiritual doulas, or it's all kind of doulas now, apparently, like financial doulas, spiritual doulas. I don't know. All kinds of doulas. So, yeah, I got my shirt on too, by the way. And so I wanted to cover my part first because I can speak for me. I don't refer to myself as any kind of doula. So let me cover my part first. So I do use coach sometimes because I like that. Live in peace. I do call myself a coach sometimes because I know that that's what people are accustomed to hearing. The reason that that was not my choice to be called a coach is because, for one thing, I don't think it covers what I do. A lot of times when you see coaches, you see people that are like motivational speakers. You know, it's like, yeah, you can do it. You can do it. Come on, Passion. I'm calling Passion out because she ain't here. But come on, Passion. You can do it. You can do it. You can do it. And they're just telling you that you're enough and you're awesome and you're great and you're da-da-da-da. But I've seen that a lot of times they don't require as much work as I do. So because I'm a guide, I think of myself like your mother guides you. I expect work. Like if you work with me, you're going to have to work. You're going to have to go to those dark places that you didn't want to touch. And like your mom, I'm not moved by your tears. I care that you're upset. But it's not going to make me stop digging. And it's not going to make me encourage you to stop digging. I'm going in like, you know, to go into the dark places and sweep them out and say, hey, you know, come on, let's get this work. I hate that you're crying like that, but come on, let's get it anyway. Take a minute to yourself. Come on back. Those kind of things. I'm not a babysitter. I give out assignments. I give lots of homework. I expect for you to complete said homework. If you are stuck, that's okay. But if you're being lazy, I will probably not work with you very long. So, because traditionally when we talked about guys and shamans and things like that in our communities, what we were talking about were people who we had to meet their requirements. These were the people who took us through rites of passages. These were the people who took us through those difficult markers in our lives. That's my job, is to take you through the difficult markers in your life. So when you get to those points in your life where you have to make a decision or you have to make a change or, you know, things like, that's me. I really, the other little stuff, I'm like, you're an adult. You can handle that. You know what I'm saying? I'm the one that wants to take you on the modern day vision quest, meaning that you're out in the desert, you're out alone, you just like, oh shit, I don't know how I'm gonna make it out of this. I want to guide you through that. I'm not the rah-rah girl. I'm not a cheerleader. If you need to be coaxed and petted on and begged and prodded and constantly encouraged, no. When you come to me, you need to already be ready to work. So that's why I choose God, because I feel like calling myself a God is more in line with, one, our traditions, our indigenous traditions. And because a lot of what I do, what I found is, if we still had our rites of passages in place for the different periods and times in our lives when we go through these changes and transitions, we wouldn't have a lot of problems that we have. So that's why I call myself that. As far as people using the title doula or midwife and things like that, I think what they're saying is that they feel like they can help you birth forth your dream or birth forth your vision or birth your business or whatever it is. Is somebody kind of give you that emotional support to birth something out. So I guess that's why they use that name. Like I said, I just kind of was going to touch on it because that's not my thing. I don't call myself a doula of any sort. I don't call myself a midwife of any sort. I've never really have even been interested in that thing. And I know as a woman, it's like, oh my God, I can't believe she said that. I'm not. The only kind of midwifery I'm interested in, honestly, is the, they call it a death midwife or a transition midwife or a transition doula, things like that. The thing that I'm interested in is not birth to this realm. It is to help you birth a transition to the next realm. That's my next, one of my next things that I want to be certified in. That's also another reason I was convinced that I was a child of Oya, because I'm weirdly comfortable with death. Like, I'm strangely comfortable with it. So I just knew, like, you know, I was like, yeah, I'm a child of Oya, you know, da da da. And I was like, they was like, nah, you're not. Not even a little bit. Like, I don't even think Oya ever showed up in a reading I've had. So, yeah, that's my answer to the question. So I didn't see her popping. Yeah, Passion, you know, we'd be like the daughters of Ashun, because you're a daughter of Oya, right? But the daughter, I have not met a daughter of Ashun yet that did not think she was a child of Oya first. All of us be like Oya groupies and shit, you know. You are too. Which one, Tamara? No, Tia and Tamara. Tamara. Which one? You a daughter of Ashun or Oya? Epa, Yanza, it's two of y'all in here? Wait, I didn't know that. I did not know that. I did not know that. Did you? I didn't know it went the reverse. I just know all of us was like, oh, Club Oya. So, and I guess another reason is because I've always dreamt of tornadoes, which have always been indicative of change and things like that, which is also another component to, or another thing that I focus on in my work as a guide, is that yes, I'm coming to bring change. If I can be a nice gentle wind to bring you coolness, you know, then awesome. But if I gotta come in and rip your shit up, I'll do that too. Because really at the end of the day, what you're paying me for is, you're paying me for your life to be different when I'm done with you. Now, it can be gentle, or we can tear everything up. Whichever one. I don't think so. Not that I remember. I have to go look back. I think I have all of my readings I've ever gotten, ever. And I don't remember her ever showing up. So, yeah, tell the club up, for real. Because I believe in, if we're working to, and I'm going to tell you, if we're working together for a month, which is a really small a really small span of time, believe it or not. I'm probably coming to tear your whole life up, flip it on its head, because then I will, because then I have work to do. I have to get this shit done. So if you're paying me to help you figure this stuff out, I'm gonna do my work. You know, I'm coming to work. I'm gonna do my part. And so you're gonna do yours if you're working with me. Like I don't tolerate anything else. So no, I'm not. I'm probably that's part of why I have never considered myself a coach. Because I see most coaches are associated also with being like motivational speakers. Yay, you can do it. Come on. And I'm just like, you grown. Come on, let's get this work. You paid for this. This your time. You got a month. Hell, you can spend it however you want to. If you want to sit around and bullshit, that's your dime. If you want to sit on the phone, you know, we got an hour session or whatever, and you want to sit on the phone and cry the entire time and you don't want to do any work, I'll probably tell you, okay, you should probably save that that raw emotion like that for, I don't even try. I try to be, I'm understanding, but I'm not, I don't have no titty milk for you. You can't breastfeed around here, okay? My clients are on meat already. My clients are on, you know, on table food. I'm not a titty feeder kind of coach, guy and all that. Yeah, I don't do that. But I have told people in the past, you may want to save those raw emotions and those manipulative tears for a lover or your friend or something like that, because I came here to work. And that's what you paid me for. So I generally try to make sure that people know what kind of person I am when they sign up. Because I am a teacher first. Well, I'm a student first, but I'm a teacher. I love learning. I love exploring. I love asking questions. One of my favorite t-shirts that my husband bleached was this shirt that said question everything. And that's one of my main things. That's one of my main tools when you're working with me, is asking questions, and nothing is off limits. Cause I'm finna figure this shit out. You know what I'm saying? Cause that's what you're paying me for. So anyway, I just wanted to dip in and ask that question. Like I said, if y'all have any questions, y'all can inbox them to me. I will do an episode on whatever the question is. And, yeah. And this shirt is one of the ones that's available. Pussy Power shirt. Of course, it's got coochies and all this stuff. Isn't that awesome? And I'm going to tell y'all why I got red, even though that's not what we're talking about. But, I mean, it's my Periscope, so I can do what I want to. but I got red because I've been trying to start marking my moon cycle, my Ashe coming on, my blood time, my sacrificial vessel time, my walking cauldron time, my magic, my blood magic, all that, whatever you call yours, right? I've been trying to mark it with wearing red so that I can appreciate it a little bit more, and so I can be aware, because the colors will keep me aware of what kind of power I'm walking in during this time. So I think that's all. So yeah, but I did want to wear this so y'all could. Okay. You got it? And I will say this while I'm on here. If you get a slim fit of any of these shirts, get a size up. I've been trying to put that when I see people posting or whatever, you know, about it and size and stuff. If you get the slim fit, get a size larger than what you usually wear. This is a large. This is a large. I wear a medium most of the time. So I got a size up. And you can see it's still, let me push it back some. It's still like a nice little, I have room down here. But you know, the girls look, they do look awesome though. My girls. Ba-da-ding. So, and it's not a tight fit here. I don't like these necklines anyway. No. The regular one it should be true to size. The Wild Women that's not going anywhere. It was the other Pussy Power shirt. The Wild Women is going to be a standing shirt. That's going to be one that is always there. But what I do, because I don't like this, I usually cut, let me show y'all how I cut my shirts, because it'll be cut the next time you see it. But I usually cut right here on the seam, and then I cut to this seam to get that off the shoulder. You can also just cut it wider, because I just don't like all that stuff up around my throat. Feel like I'm choking, but I had to keep it on for the people. I had to get the people what they want. So yeah, there's this, the Wild Women Do As They Please shirt will always be there. That's going to be a shirt, and I'm going to actually come out with a special edition one for my birthday month, which is June, and I'm actually a solstice baby. The longest day of the year is actually my birthday. So one day I should do a Periscope about ways to celebrate your moon time in a way. You know what? Maybe I should click off and come back and we can talk about cycles. Do y'all want to do that? Let me know. Let me know. You can heart it up. You can say something. But let me know if you want me to click off and then do a separate Periscope talking about moon cycles. Because I'm on mine right now and I'm kind of feeling myself. Okay, hearts for moon cycles. Okay. I will be back. Ha ha ha.